it safe to say that Letitia and Martell are two of the most idiotic people I have ever seen on reality TV? Am I the only one who thinks that? Because if I am, y'all need to be checked, because they are both stupid. What's the business, y'all? This be your boy, Scotty by Nature TV, and we're here for another review of Love and Marriage Huntsville. What is going on, y'all? Y'all already know. This is becoming one of my most favorite reality shows that's on TV right now. Carlos King did his thing when he brought Bill Collective down here, and he did his thing when he brought Love and Marriage to Huntsville, okay? Let them know that the people in the Dirty South, we really can get the shit crunk for y'all entertainment, okay? I do it all the time with my YouTube reviews, okay? So without any further ado, let's get into the mess. Now, we start off with Marceau. Now, Marceau is at this bar that he's trying to open up or whatever, and he's talking to whoever that girl was, and he's talking about he wants this here, that here, he wants a brunch area, he wants a bar, he wants this, he wants that. So he's really trying to make it work and get it on and on and on and on and on, okay, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So one thing about Marceau is, first of all, for whatever reason, I found Marceau attractive. I don't know why I found Marceau attractive, but I do, and I think that he's fucking funny. He can be a little bit messy, and he can be a little bit misogynistic, but I do find him to be fine, in a sense, some kind of way. Don't ask me why. So then Martell comes into the building with his pig ear ass, okay? Pig feet ear ass bitch. Okay, he comes into the building, and then they start discussing, you know, how the last time Martell was there, it was just a construction site. Now it's almost ready, and he is really proud of Marceau and all this other stuff. So then they start talking about the deal that Marceau was given by Chris about that 40-some acres of land that he wanted to put some apartments on. Martell said the problem is we can't even sell the land at this point, being that everything that's been going on with me and Mel in the blogs and stuff, and don't nobody really want to take a chance on doing business with me because of my image right now. So, you know, that's what's wrong. So Marceau was like, it's funny to me how Martell has been going through all of this stuff, and now it's fucking up what he got going on. So Marceau talking about, I really want you and Mel to hit rock bottom. So when he says that, Martell is like, okay, so why would you want us to hit rock bottom? And so basically Marceau was basically, in so many words, saying when you hit rock bottom, you got to find your way right on back up, because if you never hit rock bottom, you don't know what it feels like to be in rock bottom. But Martell was like, I'm prepared for rock bottom. No the fuck you're not. You're not prepared for rock bottom. You want to know why you're not prepared for rock bottom, bitches? Because you're not going to allow it to happen. You're going to make sure you don't hit below, you know, hit rock bottom. You're going to make sure that, because you always got to come out on top. You got to do whatever the fuck you can. You got to make everybody look bad for you to come out on top, because that's what the fuck you do. That's what you always going to forever do, is do whatever the fuck you can to make everybody else look bad so you can be on top. That's what your bitch ass be doing, and that's why I don't fucking respect you, bitch. That's what the fuck you be doing, and that's just what it is. So, no, you're not ready. You're not ready. You're not prepared to be at rock bottom. You're not prepared for that. You want to know why you're not prepared for that? Because you're not going to let it happen. Just like right now, you just got done going live with your kids with those rehearsed ass answers to make Marcus look bad and make Mel look bad. You working overtime to get full custody of those fucking kids so everybody else can look bad and you can look like the fucking hero. That's what bitch ass niggas do. That's what narcissistic ass bitches do. That's what bitches with muscles do. Bitches like you do that. So, no. You're not ready for shit. You're going to always forever do what you can to make everybody else look bad. You're gonna do whatever you can to make yourself look like a victim and vilify everybody else for the shit that you have done. Okay, so it is what it is. Now, Melody, one of my favorite TV moms, Marlene. Okay, Marlene comes over to visit Melody or whatnot, and they start discussing, like, everything that's been going on with Martell and Melody. You can tell that Marlene really does love Melody. You know, she still sees her as her daughter-in-law, which is sweet. And they having a conversation. So she asks, you know, Melody was like, he's working overtime to get people to believe that I was out there cheating on him. So Marlene was like, were you cheating on him? She said, when I was talking to this dude, I talked to a man for 3 weeks. I wasn't living with Martell. I had got my own apartment. I wasn't even with this nigga. So therefore, I wasn't even cheating. Like, yeah, I talked to him for 3 months, but nothing happened. We didn't sleep together or nothing like that. We didn't go out on no dates. We just talked, and that's just what it is. And to me, people may consider that cheating, but I don't think there was an emotional connection. And she already said there was no sexual connection, so it's really not cheating. Maybe it was just somebody that she talked to let some steam off or something like that. I don't necessarily think that that's cheating. Plus, she wasn't even with him. Like, they weren't even together. On paper, they're married, but they weren't together when they were separated at the time. So, it's really not cheating. Therefore, he can use that shit all he wants to, but he had a whole 5-year relationship with another woman while he was fucking married for 5 years, had a relationship with another woman for 5 years, and then got her pregnant, and then caught her pissing on TV, but still went back to her, let her serve him up, and get her pregnant. That's what the fuck he did. So, no, that's no comparison. And then they started talking about the fact that he wants to get full custody of the kids, and Marlene was like, we're not doing no full custody. And Melody was like, well, I guess he wants y'all to take care of them full time. And then Marlene said, now, you know, I love my babies now, but I ain't finna raise no kids now. He needs to stop it with the full custody stuff. And he really does need to stop with the full custody stuff, because Martell is just being a low-down, dirty-ass dog. Woof, woof. That's what the fuck he doing, being a low-down, dirty-ass dog. That's all he can be. That's all he knows how to be. And you know, it's just it's sad to see him go out like a bitch, but he's only going out where he is, and he's just a bitch, period. So Marceau is working, and Letitia, with her stupid ass, she comes into the building, and she says that she has a surprise for him. So she goes and take him outside, and she got them in a pod having dinner or whatnot. So she surprises him for dinner, basically to say that, you know, after his accident, she just wants to show him how much she appreciate him. She wants to surprise him for dinner because of the wreck, but she doesn't want to surprise him with dinner to apologize for allowing her mom to disrespect him in her face and her not say a word about it. That's what the dinner should be for, but it's not. So I'm just trying to understand what the fuck is the point. But Letitia is stupid as fuck. She don't think her mama wrong, so of course this ain't got nothing to do with Dottie Peoples. This is more so about the accident. Girl, shut the fuck. I can't stand Letitia, y'all. I cannot stand her. But Marceau went right on back to this misogynistic ass bullshit that he talks about how he wants her to stay at home, deal with the kids while he out working. That ain't gonna happen. It's not gonna happen. Like, just stop it. And while she's on at dinner with her husband, here she go talking about mail. Like, girl, this supposed to be about you and your man. Like, why you talking about an ex-friend? Like, girl, focus on your man, not your ex-friend. Because your ex-friend ain't focused on you. So shut the hell up and focus on your man. So Melody and Martell, they meet up to exchange the kids. Mel's week with the kids is over with. Now it's time for Martell's week with the kids. And as she's trying to walk away, you know what I'm saying? He pulls her away. He wants to have a conversation with her, and she don't want to have no conversation with him, but he wants to have a conversation with her, and she's already over it already, which I don't blame her, because what the fuck y'all got to talk about? He wants to talk about the full custody battle, and she's saying that you going around telling people that you want to have full custody of the kids. He said, I already sent that to the courts and all this other stuff. And I'm just like, if you already sent it to the courts, then what's the fucking point of y'all having a discussion about it? You already know what you want to do. You already know what you gonna do. So what's the fuck is the point of y'all even talking about this? Like, what's the fucking point, my nigga? Like, are you serious? And so then he wants to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. It's like, you can't live without creating strife between you and this woman. The woman dropped off the kids so you can take your kids for a week and leave her the fuck alone. Why you gotta keep on presenting the same argument? You wanna keep on talking about how she's lying, how she's doing this, how she's doing that. To be honest, you both of y'all getting on my nerves. Mel, if you over him and you don't wanna talk to him, you don't have to give him no fucking conversation. You all need to have a go-between at this fucking point, because y'all cannot be around each other long enough to have a conversation like adults. Martell just need to grow the fuck up. That's really what his issue is. And then she said, your mama told me that you got a son. And she walked the fuck off, and Martell ain't got shit else to say. And then he want to say that she acting like a child. Nigga, you wrote the book on acting like a child, so fuck all that. So this conversation with Kimmy, Maurice, and Jalen really annoyed me. Like, it's annoying the hell out of me, and I'm going to tell you why. Because Jalen just graduated from from college. Jalen is in his early 20s. Nobody has it figured out in their early 20s. Nobody does. It may be a small fraction, but not everybody does. And I need for Maurice to stop pressuring him. Like, why are you pressing him? Like, it's not like he's sitting at home not doing shit. The man goes to a 9-to-5 every fucking day. He does. So it's not like he's not making his own money. It's not that he's mooching off of any of y'all. He just doesn't know what he wants to do. And that's just what it is. Because when I was that age and I was in college, I really didn't want to go to college. I honestly didn't. I was tired of school and I honestly didn't want to go to college. Now, I was going to college to go into my field, which was mass comm. You know what I mean? But I really wasn't feeling the college thing. And that's probably why I winded up flunking out and never going back. And then years later, I come and realize that I didn't really have to go to college to do what the fuck I'm doing right now. So it is what it is. So I was at that age where I really didn't know what I wanted to do. And I was sitting there. But unlike Jalen, I sat at home for most of my 20s. Because after I dropped out of college, well, after I flunked out of college, let me say that, after I flunked out of college, I had to be like 21. So from 21 on up to about 24, I was at home. Like, I was at home, I wasn't working, I was only doing videos. That's all I was doing. So, with that being said, stop pressing this man. It is what it is. I get that Maurice loves Jalen as his own. I totally understand that. I wish my stepfather was like that and he wants to encourage him. But it's more than encouragement at this point. Like, you're pressuring him to go into being an entrepreneur. Being an entrepreneur isn't for everybody. Like, everybody ain't about that entrepreneur life. Some people want to work, and that's just what it is. So you got to respect that. You can't be pushing stuff on him and forcing stuff on him. Because just like you said, you got one person over here telling me to do this, and then you got another person over here telling me to do that. So the conversation is not going to help him overall. So you're just going to have to let him do him the best way that he fucking can. It is what it is, child. Like, So it's time for the day treat that Destiny put together for herself, Kimmy, Letitia and Mel. Okay, so that's what they're doing. Letitia is late, but when she finally gets there, she's fucking annoying. Like, she's annoying as fuck, and she's sitting up here talking about, well, it seems to me like the ladies were already having fun without me. You damn right, you late. What the hell you expect? Them to sit there and cry because you ain't there yet? Like, this girl is probably the most childish ass girl I have ever seen in my life. Like, shut the fuck up. Like, how childish and how stupid are you? Like, listen, y'all know, it's a couple of people on reality TV that I just don't see it for, that I just can't stand it. I would never, ever see it for. You got Marie, you got Portia, who else do I can't stand? You got Rashida, you got, who else? Give me somebody else. You got Chrissy, you got Rashida Ali, who else, baby? Who else? It's certain people that I got on reality TV that I would never, ever, 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 ever in my life see it for. Evelyn Lozada, Shawnee O'Neal, Jennifer Williams, like those Phaedra Parks, those type of women. Those are women that I would never, ever, 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 ever see it for, period. Letitia follows those same women because she's stupid as fuck, and I don't find her intelligent at all. I don't give a damn how many degrees she got. She's not intelligent. She's a dumbass, okay? And I just can't see, like, she's immature as hell, and I just can't see it for her. Like, she's so fucking dumb. Like, I have, like, let me tell y'all something about me. Let me tell you something about me, period. Like, I am annoyed by ignorance, and that girl is ignorant as fuck. Her ignorance cup is up here, okay? She's so fucking dumb, I can't take it. So, I think her name is Ima. Melody's friend arrives, and here go Letitia. I don't know what she's saying. She's speaking a different language. You have the nerve to talk about somebody speaking a different language, girl. Like, really? Have you ever heard yourself talk? Girl, shut the fuck up. Then Melody starts talking about her workaholic spirit. She gets that from her father, you know what I mean? So she starts talking about her struggles as a workaholic. She always feel like she got to go get it by any means necessary. Kimmy starts talking about control. She has a control issue. She's seen it within her family. Letitia starts talking about how she would be around her girlfriends and see how they get in love for their mom, but she never really got that love from Dottie Peoples. It shows. Then Melody and Destiny have a touching conversation about their relationship and how Destiny feels protected when she's with Melody. And I thought that was very sweet, because that kind of reminds me of me and Jamar's relationship. Like, me and Jamar are like this. We are equally yoked. We are two different people, but we are each other's spirit animal. And that's just how I feel about, that's how me and Jamar is, or me and Josiah, or me and Terrence. Like, I love those three. I always have to say it all the time. I love those three guys to death. Terrence, Josiah, and Jamar are my three besties on YouTube, because I have different, like, I have relationships with them outside of the camera, and I talk to them all the time. So yeah, I have to talk about those three all the time. Then we get into Letitia and Mel. Now Letitia starts talking about her issue with Mel. Here's my thing. Now, as much as I don't like Letitia, I'm just gonna say this. Mel just needs to own up to her part in the situation, because neither one of y'all are completely innocent. If you sat up there and you said that you had some tea on her man and you did not release it, then you just need to shut the fuck up about it. And that's just point blank in the fuck, period. Like, straight up. Like, for real. Like, if you're not gonna tell the tea at all, just shut the fuck up. Like, how would you feel if something, like, for real though, like, you sit up here talking about, you steady sitting up here saying, okay, I know more about your life than you do. What do you know then? Why don't you just spit it out? I don't understand. I don't get it. Like, Melody should own up to her shit, and Letitia should own up to hers too. Both of y'all motherfuckers are wrong, and both of y'all are hurt, and neither one of y'all can make things work out, or y'all too stubborn to see the other point of view of the other person. That's just what it is. Both of y'all need to shut the hell up, and both of y'all look stupid and annoying as fuck, because the woman telling you what you did, Mel and Letitia, the woman asking you what the fuck she did, and you ain't telling her. Like, both of y'all need to own it and just shut the fuck up, period. But with that being said, y'all, that's that women shit. With that being said, y'all, this be your boy Scattered by Nature. This is my review. If you want to follow me on social media, both my Twitter and my Instagram are below. And make sure y'all like, rate, comment, subscribe, and share this video, and do whatever you see fit, y'all. And I'm out here. Till next time, peace out.